Hello and welcome to my recording session about design patterns in Java. My name is Alexander, freelancer. I am a Java developer too. And so by any means, if you're interested in work with me, you have contact emails and website and such and such. I provide different kind of services, creating automatic unit tests, making sure that your quality is great of the software. Creating requirements engineering if it needs to be done, and helping other potential candidates to get hired in German companies. So if you're interested in working with me, you just can try to reach me out. So today I want to speak about, but about the design pattern. It is a design pattern adapter. And design pattern adapter have three parts, actually two parts. The first part, it is your class, and the second is adapter, which wraps your class, and then other class. So basically your adapter wraps the object which it need to be wrapped, and then all calls from happening from outside through adapter, and adapter then calls the wrapped object. So it is based on the book Head First Design Patterns. The book itself gives certain information about it, about the way how it goes, and understanding what the purpose of the adapter in any way. As I understand, it helps you to wrap your class interface and provide access from to the classes which normally would not be allowed to do that because of the incompatible interfaces. But additionally, what to say about adapter? Adapter converts one interface to another, and it makes sure that you can use the wrapped object from the class which have some different, pretty different interface. So it basically helps you to have an intent in the adapter, which allow you to use your wrapped object from different class. Let me show you actually the example, and then you understand even more. The code which you see, let me just put it down. So I took the example from the Head First Design Patterns book. It's a example of the duck. Duck adapter, and how it works. First of all, I have my duck, which is an interface. It is then implemented by the duck adapter class. Duck adapter class implements the, actually, if you look it up, duck adapter implements Turkey interface. And the duck implemented by the, let me just click it. So Turkey adapter implements duck. So let's just look the tests. I'm making sure that I can instantiate the different types of object. Actually, this is pretty different. Different test, adapter test. So I have here Turkey adapter, Turkey interface, duck adapter, and I'm making sure that I can create Turkey adapter object, duck adapter object, Mallard duck object, and such and such. The thing which you need to understand, I will show you. Let me just put my console back. I'm using Eclipse, as you see. So how it works? I have here duck interface, turkey interface, and there I assign my normal instances from the class duck and from the class wild turkey. So my mallard duck is instance of the mallard duck class, and wild turkey is the instance of the wild turkey class. And how they look like? And I shall mention the code which you see here is on the GitHub. You can always download it from the GitHub. Here you have wild turkey class, which implements turkey interface. And the same goes to the mallard duck, which implements duck interface. But we working with an interface, so how it's really actually how it actually works. So if you look it closely, you're creating your turkey adapter and then assign the turkey interface, and the whole object which is turkey adapter goes and wrapped by the turkey adapter. And then I can pass it to my method in the test class, and then it will print something, some messages from the turkey. So let me just execute the code. I'm doing in this environment execution of the commands. So let me just quickly make it sure that you can see what's happening. So, and also stuff. I actually want to have it in. Wait a second. Yep, it sometimes happens. Let me just quickly do that. Okay. I must say I recording this second time and it's kind of funny. Okay, so the first message which we see, let me just do it, the whole code and then the output of the console. So the first message which we see is from turkey, and the turkey says, and here I am calling the turkey interface, gobble and fly. The turkey says gobble gobble, I'm flying a short distance. Then I do test duck. Duck interface. And don't forget that in duck interface I saving the instance of mallard duck object. And here I have quack, I'm flying, so it works. Now more interesting stuff. The turkey adapter says, and here I have test duck. In test duck, I passing through the turkey adapter, and the duck is a method of the its interface actually. It's an interface. So here I have my turkey adapter, and then you see it prints gobble gobble. I'm flying a short distance. And the main point of adapter to wrap the object, and you have difference of how many classes you can wrap, but the intent of the adapter is to alter the interface so that it match one client and it's what it's expecting. So intent of the facet will be something different, but for my understanding, it's pretty simple with adapter. It can be complicated, I agree, but actually an adapter you have, let me draw it quickly. You have your, let me write, let me quickly draw. Oops, two times in a row. So, You have here one and one crash. So now I'm starting to do the right stuff.
Me.
Let me try something new. Okay. So here you have your duck. It is in a adapter. Duck adapter. And here you have, like, I don't know, robot duck, which want to have the behavior of the duck. It calls the adapter, and adapter sends the behavior states of the duck through the itself. But the major thing I must repeat with the adapter is a conversion of one interface to another, because previously it was not possible to have such connections. If you have two different interfaces which implemented by different kind of classes, and if you don't use a adapter pattern, it's kind of hard. So once again, I repeat last time, what is adapter function is. Adapter function is to convert the interface of a given class into another interface which the caller client class is expecting, and it lets many classes to work together, which previously it wasn't incompatible interfaces. So I have many classes with different interfaces, and I cannot do work with the interfaces when it's incompatible to one to another. And adapter allow you to have the case where you can connect two or many incompatible interfaces. But it's like, if you want to know how I can simplify it, it's like you have, I don't know, special outlet, power outlet, and you have here, I don't know, two connections type. And this is my adapter. And here you have, from this side, you have, I don't know, something like that. And here you have your class, which is really what you're trying to connect to the another incompatible class. So I know I have some bubbling through, but if you look the code which is available on GitHub, I think you will understand the idea. And I hope this time my recording works. So thank you for watching my learning session. I will try in next video to show you a facet pattern. And that's it for me. Thank you.